This video demonstrates how to animate objects in Plant Simulation 3D. We will show you how you can animate a built-in plant simulation object. You can use the same techniques to animate your own objects. To begin, start Plant Simulation and create a new 3D model by clicking Create New Model. We create our own station as we have learned in the video Hierarchical Modeling. We open the folder User Objects in the class library. It contains an empty frame which we can use. If you want to create another frame, select the folder User Objects. Click the right mouse button and select New and then Frame. If our frame contains a graphic called Under Construction, we delete this graphic. We then insert a station and two interfaces into the frame and connect the interfaces and the station. In our station, we want to move the tool holder from the position in the center to the left end, then to the right end, and back to the center. After this, the moving object, our part, can leave the station. First, we have to step into the graphic of the station. Select the station, click the right mouse button, and select Open in New 3D Window. Now we can manipulate each graphical element of the station. We select the tool holder, click the right mouse button, and select Make Animatable Object. In the dialog that opens, we type in a meaningful name. We named our animatable object Tool Holder. You'll notice that the program shows white helper lines denoting the origin of the tool holder. You can also see the coordinates of the white lines in the dialog. Set the origin of the x-axis to 0 and of the y-axis to 0.6 meters. Click OK to close the dialog. Now we want to determine the position when the tool holder is located on the left side. For this, we pick the tool holder and move it to the left. Click the right mouse button and open the dialog, Edit 3D Properties. We remember that the position of the tool holder in the X direction is located at about minus 0.8 meters. We move the tool holder to the right to find the right end position. Then we open the dialog, Edit 3D Properties. The right end position is located at 0.8 meters. We then move the tool holder to the center again. Now we can define the animation paths of the tool holder. Click the right mouse button and select Edit 3D Properties. Click the tab Self Animation. On this tab, we will define the paths on which the tool holder moves. Click Add to add a new path. We name the path Left and click OK to create it. Now we select the new path and click Edit. In the dialog which opens, we only see a single line, which defines the default position of the tool holder. The path starts at the position 0. Click Add to add an additional anchor point for the path. We select the new anchor point and click Edit Values. Instead, you can also double-click it to modify the values. Next, we are going to define the time, which the tool holder needs to move from the position in the center to the position on the left. To do so, double-click the first anchor point. In the Edit dialog, select the checkbox Velocity and enter 1 second into the text box, time. Click OK twice to close the dialog windows. Click Play in the Properties dialog that is still open. This will play the animation we just defined. Now, we define an animation from the left side to the right side, just as we did above. This represents processing of the part, and therefore, the speed of the movement will be slow. Click Add in the dialog Self-Animation. We named our path Right. Click OK. Now, we select the animation path named Right and click Edit. Double-click the first row and set the x-coordinate to -0.8. This means that the animation starts on the left side. Activate Velocity and enter 20 seconds as the time the movement takes. Click OK. Next, we click Add to add the endpoint of the movement. We double-click the endpoint and enter 0.8 meters as the x-coordinate of the endpoint. Click OK twice to close the open dialogs. We select the path Right and click Play to check if our path definition works as intended. Finally, we add a third animation path and name it Middle. This path starts at 0.8 meters. That is at the right side of the station and ends at the middle of the station. For this movement, the tool holder takes 1 second. The second anchor point of the animation path is the center point of the station. Now we are done defining the animation paths of the tool holder. Close all dialog windows and close the window of the station. We add a method to the frame of our station and name it onEntrance. Double-click the graphic of the station to open the dialog. We set the processing time to 22 seconds. 1 second moving to the left, 20 seconds moving to the right, and 1 second moving to the center again. We also define a recovery time of 5 seconds. The recovery time should start after the part has left the station. We change to the tab Controls and select the method onEntrance as our entrance control. Click OK to close the dialog. Double-click the method onEntrance. In the first line, we check if 3D is active and if the animation of the moving objects is active as well. Next, we get all animations of the tool holder and store them in the variable named animations. The method resetAnimation resets all animations that have not been played, so that the animation starts at the default position. First, we schedule the animation named left to be played. The method play plays the animation. We wait 1 second until the animation has been finished. Next, we reset the animation again to make sure that the following animation will start with the respect to the middle of the station. The movement to the right is now scheduled and played. We have to wait 20 seconds until the movement will be finished. Finally, the tool holder will be moved to the center. We have to wait 1 second for the end of the movement. Using the station named My Station, which we just built, we want to build a simulation model. We create a new frame in the class library. Add a source, My Station, and a drain. We connect all objects and add an event controller. We reset and start the simulation and watch how the tool holder moves while the part is processed. This concludes our video about animating an object.